The internet wants to know, so let's give them some answers. Welcome back to the Tarantula Collective. My name is Richard, and today we are wrapping up answering some of the internet's most asked questions about tarantulas. If you're new to the channel, I upload videos every Tuesday and Friday, so if you enjoy content about tarantulas, scorpions, and other inverts and exotic pets, please consider subscribing so you don't miss any new content. Now, this is the third video in a three-part series, so if you missed the first two videos, I will have them linked at the end so you can catch up. And we are jumping right in with the next question, which is, where do tarantulas live? And the answer is, well, tarantulas can be found living on almost every continent in the world, obviously not Antarctica. It is believed that tarantulas first appeared hundreds of millions of years ago in the area now known as Central Mexico and Central America, when all the continents were joined in one large landmass known as Pangaea. They began to spread out and evolve and were separated as continental drift began causing tarantulas in different areas to evolve and adapt to their specific environment over millions of years, branching off into over 1,000 different species. When you look at the disbursement of tarantulas around the world, they typically can be found in what is known as the coffee belt, which is the part of the world where the environment is suited for growing coffee beans. This is between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn. Across the globe, within this region, you can typically find different species of tarantula that have evolved to survive in that habitat. It should be noted that this is a generalization, and there are areas within the coffee belt where no tarantulas can be found, and there may be a few species of tarantula that live outside of the Tropic of Cancer or the Tropic of Capricorn. But tarantulas have adapted to survive in different altitudes, temperatures, and levels of humidity, and can be found living in burrows in the ground, on the surface, or even off the ground in bushes and trees. And as people spread out in these areas, tarantulas have adapted to live on fence posts, on or in homes and buildings, and almost any area where they can find a quiet, dark place to make shelter from the elements and predators. The next question on the list is, where can you buy a pet tarantula? Now, this answer will depend a lot on where you live and the laws of your governments regarding keeping exotic non-native species as pets. For the most part, tarantulas can be found for sale as pets in exotic pet stores and even some chain pet stores. Also, many places around the world have reptile or exotic pet conventions or expos where you can find all manner of exotic pets, enclosures, and supplies for sale. And more likely than not, there will be people there selling tarantulas as well. The easiest and probably most reliable way to get a pet tarantula these days is to order them online from a reputable dealer. The internet has really facilitated the growth of the tarantula hobby and made many more species available to pet owners than ever before. With online buying becoming more and more popular, it has made it easier and more profitable to breeders and dealers to carry more rare species or species that typically were never in the pet hobby. Buying from reputable online dealers also helps to ensure that you are purchasing captive bred specimens, which can mean they are more adapted to live in captivity and will have a higher survival rate. Also, you know you aren't contributing to the collection of wild tarantulas or even the illegal capture, smuggling, and sale of wild specimens for the pet trade. It is important to make sure you are buying captive bred species so as not to be part of the dangerous and destructive practice of removing wild tarantulas from their environment in large numbers just to be sold as pets. It may seem strange or even dangerous ordering tarantulas online, but there are a lot of well-respected dealers on the internet that have been doing this for many years and have developed methods of shipping tarantulas safely across the country all year long. And every reputable dealer offers a live arrival guarantee. So if, in the unfortunate circumstance, the tarantula were to die while being shipped, they will replace the spider at no charge to you. Notice I have said reputable many times, as there are, like with anything, fly-by-night businesses that pop up out of nowhere or businesses widely known for selling wild-caught specimens or practicing unsafe shipping procedures. I have a list of online dealers I recommend on my website, and some have even provided discount codes so you can save a little extra money. This is not a definitive list by any means, but you can always ask what dealers people recommend in any pet tarantula forum and get a wide variety of responses for great dealers. There are even some people that sell amazing species of spiders that do not have a website and post the list of species they have available on forums like Arachnoboards or Tarantula forums. And though they may not have as wide of a selection as dealer websites, the species these breeders are selling can sometimes be less expensive. When buying from an individual, it is highly advisable In fact, very important that you check the reviews of the seller and make sure you are looking at recent reviews. Anytime someone sends you an unsolicited message offering to sell you spiders, or a newly created account with no reviews is posting list of species available for sale, you should practice extreme caution and never send them money that you cannot get refunded if the deal goes south. If it is too good to be true, it probably is. So buyer beware. Get references and read reviews, and never send money for the purchase of tarantulas using friends and family on PayPal or any service that does not give you the ability to request a refund or refute the charges if the seller does not hold up their end of the deal. But protect yourself. Don't get scammed. And only order from reputable businesses with mostly good reviews, responsible shipping methods, and a genuine passion for tarantulas. Now, this next question is a tough one to answer, but I'm definitely going to try. And that is, how long do tarantulas live? Well, this answer depends not only on the species of the tarantula, but also on the tarantula's sex. Typically, females live much longer than males, which is why they are usually the most sought after and most expensive. Most tarantulas available for sale are spiderlings or baby tarantulas, and the sex is not known. Dwarf species usually have the shortest lifespans, living around 8 to 12 years, but there are many other larger species with similar lifespans. Some males in these species may only live 2 to 4 years max. While on the other hand, there are many New World terrestrial species where females have been recorded living over 30 years in captivity. So lifespan runs the gamut from a few years to multiple decades, depending on whether they are male or female, New World or Old World, terrestrial, fossorial, or arboreal. Once you determine what species you have or plan on getting, you can find plenty of resources with typical age ranges for male and females of that species. Now here's another great question that I'm sure a lot of you all I've seen before, or maybe even have yourself, and that is, why do tarantulas have hair, or why does my tarantula have a bald spot on their abdomen? Tarantulas are covered in setae, and New World species also possess urticating hairs. The hairs on tarantulas are actually sense organs. They are sensitive in a way that is similar to the eardrum of humans. These hairs can sense movement of air molecules caused by sound, or even from air particles getting pushed around from something moving in the immediate environment. Scientists also think hairs can sense the changes of chemicals in the air and can perceive pheromones, smells, or other changes detected with this chemotactile sense. Tarantulas do not have a nose or ears, and their eyesight is poor at best. Usually, they're only able to see movement and the differences between light and dark. The majority of the information they receive about their environment comes from these highly sensitive hairs that cover their bodies. Most New World tarantulas possess urticating hairs as well, which are a type of defensive mechanism. There are 7 different types of urticating hairs, and most tarantulas from the Americas have at least one or a combination of a few different types. I go into much more detail about urticating hairs in the video linked above if you want to get some more information. But when they feel threatened, tarantulas can kick these hairs into a cloud using their back legs or rub them on their webbing or anything they view as a threat to deter predators. These hairs lodge into the skin of any would-be attacker and can cause an allergic reaction that leads to itching or even a burning sensation. Many terrestrial species of New World tarantulas also kick these hairs down onto their thin webbing that surrounds the mouth of their burrow. This way, any unwelcome guests sniffing around will get a nose full of hairs and quickly back off in discomfort before ever finding the tarantula in hiding nearby. When a tarantula is stressed from either being introduced into a new environment or from unwanted attention, handling, or shipping, they are also known to kick off these hairs. When enough hairs have been kicked, a bald spot on the abdomen begins to appear. Some pet owners get worried, thinking their tarantula is sick or hurt, but usually it just means they were stressed out or are very defensive, or even just making themselves at home. When a tarantula molts and sheds off their old exoskeleton, the new exoskeleton that has been growing underneath will be once again covered in these hairs with no bald spot until they begin kicking hairs again. And the last question we're going to answer in this series is, what tarantula is the most aggressive? Another common question that is unfortunately misguided and comes about from misinformation, myths, and exaggerations. No species of tarantula is actually considered aggressive, though some species are known to be more defensive than others. The difference between aggressive and defensive may seem like a matter of meaningless semantics, but it is actually a very important distinction. Aggression implies that the tarantula will attack unprovoked because they are plain mean or evil. This is not an apt description of tarantula behavior. Some species of tarantula may be defensive, meaning they only react instinctively to a perceived threat on their life or well-being. For the most part, tarantulas will first attempt to escape and run away from any threat they encounter. They will dive into their burrows or quickly bolt away. If there is no readily available avenue of escape, the first line of defense is typically the threat pose. This is when a tarantula stands its ground, facing the perceived threat, and raises the first pair of legs into the air to give the appearance of being larger in size. New World tarantulas will usually kick off urticating hair as their first line of defense. If that fails to deter, then they may quickly spin around and give a threat pose. If the initial threat pose is not effective and the threat is still present or even continuing to advance, then the tarantula will exaggerate the threat pose by putting the front two pairs of legs into the air, sometimes even bending backwards to the point that their body is at a 90-degree angle. They may also begin to unfold their fangs from their body, giving a very intimidating appearance. When a tarantula gets to this stage, the only other recourse they may feel they have from continual aggravation is to slap the ground quickly or even attempt to bite. How quickly a tarantula accelerates or how defensive they are depends on the species as well as the specimen. Old World tarantulas lack urticating hair, so if they can't run and hide safely, they may immediately go straight into a full-on threat pose and start slapping the ground. Some New World species will go into a threat pose and just freeze and never slap or attempt to bite, unless they are repeatedly annoyed, and after a long period of time has passed, with all their warning signs still being ignored. Typically though, a defensive bite is a measure of last resort for a tarantula, and is usually brought on by a human disregarding these warning signs, or attempting to handle or interact with a species that has made it clear they are not willing to tolerate such behavior. Most, if not all the bite reports I have read, the person bit was either handling, attempting to handle, or rehousing a tarantula, things that cause a tarantula a lot of stress. Even sticking your hands into a tarantula's enclosure to feed, remove a water dish, or spot clean can be an unwanted action that can cause the tarantula to become defensive. Their enclosure is essentially their burrow in some cases. It is their home, their territory, where they feel safe. And even if you are crossing into their space to help them, all they perceive is that you are an intruder that may be trying to do them harm, and they may act out of self-defense. With a little patience, respect, and mindfulness, most bites from a tarantula can easily be avoided. In over 20 years keeping tarantulas, I have never been bit, and the majority of tarantula keepers can say the exact same thing. And those that have been bit are quickly able to explain how the bite was actually their fault due to negligence or continuing to push the tarantula after the team made it very clear they were uncomfortable. Using best practices for rehousing, feeding, and watering, as well as alerting your tarantula that you're opening their enclosure with a few gentle taps on the outside, will all go a long way to ensure being bit will never be an issue. Respect the tarantula and give them the space that they demand, and you will have no issues. Now, if you missed the first two videos in this series where I answer the internet's most asked questions about tarantulas, just click this playlist right here to catch up. And if you'd like to see my latest videos, just click this playlist right here. As always, I appreciate you watching. Subscribe if you want to see more. It probably needs more substrate. And I will see you next Tuesday.